This is an overview of today's struggle with MLS policy, but I think I at least have something a little bit useful now, so let's just boot up the system. It has MLS policy, a Red Hat Enterprise Linux 6.4, it's enforcing. And as you can see, everything is at least green. So everything starts properly. And I'm assuming that there are no unconfined domains, so that everything is restricted. So basically, I have here two users. They're basically both the same. So I set up a PAM as Linux to ask for a role and security level and clearance. So let's just log in ABC123, this is the password, and then it'll ask me if I want to provide a role and a level and a clearance. A level is actually probably sensitivity and a clearance. So yeah, a role is the default role is user R, and then basically the default level is basically a system low with a full clearance, and I need to basically select something non-default. So let's just take S5 and then the clearance of the full clearance C0 C1023. Now I'm just wondering how this would work if I wouldn't have full clearance, and I should actually try that out. And it's actually C0 C1023. Whoops, something went wrong there. S5, S15, C0, C1023. All right, so I logged in a very minimum desktop, at least also compared to without MLS, because well, I don't have many applets here. So let's just open a shell and get my ID. So I'm operating on sensitivity 5 with a full clearance. So let's just use xterm, because this GNOME terminal hooks into all kinds of stuff, and that's not very useful with MLS. So xterm, and then just basically let's just work from xterm. So here we have ID S5. So new role, and then just a different level. So let's just say S6. And then full clearance S15 C0 C1023 password, and now I can actually xterm another one, and now I have another one open. ID. So we are at C6, and if I exit here, then I'm back at C5. So let's just open another terminal, xterm, on C5. Xterm. you. Okay, so here we have another one. ID. ID. So the two terminals here above are at the same sensitivity, whereas the below one is not in a higher sensitivity, so the higher one cannot write down. So let's just see if I can copy and paste some stuff. So as you can see, I can actually copy and paste in this terminal, and actually also here, so that sucks. So I can actually write down. That sucks. Let's see if the it works the other way around as well. Yeah. So it actually, I'm actually able to copy from one to another, which is bad. I would have sworn that so that actually works. Sucks. I would have sworn, and I am enforcing. So yeah, nano test text, blah blah blah. And I can't actually write. Can you believe that? Because I'm not in the home directory. So got test text. And then just, yeah, that's just gonna happen. See? So that doesn't work, that copy paste stuff. That doesn't work. Now, either it's just me. Let's just PS aux. Actually PS, yeah, this is just showing my own processes anyways. And actually this one can read down, so this is actually let's just add another xsel. Now I seem to have an, no, actually this is also an external on C6. So yeah, I don't know what is going on. It's just copying and pasting. But anyways, let's see if I can read up. So that's fine. So I can't actually list processes that are on C6. So that's at least a little bit better. But still, I don't understand why I can actually copy and paste on different levels, to different levels. This is for shits and giggles, install something. Out permission denied dconf. Out of D is not running. God knows why. Let's just figure that out straight ahead. It's not even. That's probably due to C module DB, I guess. Let's see what checkconfig says about. Out of D. It's set to on, but it's actually running. No, it's not running, so I don't know why that is. I think maybe it's just anyways, let's see if it actually works or not. it's just open another gedit on a different level. But anyways, it's just copying and pasting. Because if it does that from a terminal, then I don't see why it wouldn't, why it would do that. Why it wouldn't do that like this. Copy, paste, see? So that sucks. But I think, no, it's just a bug. It's got to be a bug, because let's see if there are actually constraints on copy and paste. X pointers. Events. X source. X device, X cursor, X selection, implicit single level. Let's just. New role, LS7. Exit. New role, S7. Okay, and now Xterm. ID 7. Okay, so this here we have one on what I would call a single level. So let's just open another one. X8. Oh. S8. Xterm. And then exit. Okay, now make these small. So this one is basically with the full clearance, and the above, this one is S8, I guess. And this one is S7. So huh? Weird. Weird. Okay, let's just try that again. ID. So this is writing up. This is writing up, so let's just write down. This is S8, so that just works. Single level or not. Now I don't understand what that copy and paste shit means. But as you can see, it just works. So we did, this is the X selection. These have no restrictions. It's a resource. I'm overlooking something. What? This is supposedly a clipboard. Face ops. Let's just look at the access factors. The x-axis vectors, and they're also scattered all over the place. X-drawable, x-screen, x-font, x-column, x-cursor, x-client, x-server, x-device. So there's no clipboard. Where the hell did I get that from? X keyboard, X pointer, X application data. Level 1 dominated by level 2. Based after confirm. Application data ops. And that's just not, I'm not going to be able to actually test it out. I guess. actually that actually works. I don't understand that. Don't understand this shit. Ah. Hey, this is actually it. So it does work, I think. Because we have S1 here. And basically S6, X5. What's my ID? S5. So that's my default level is S5, so I can't write up, that's no problem, but I can't write down. See, that's not gonna happen. Yeah, this is it. Not sure what this X6 has to do with any of that shit. Cut buffer. But I think the point is that I'm not able to write down, but I don't understand why that doesn't work with Xterm itself, because, well, I'm here ID, so I wouldn't in theory be able to write down some of this stuff here, and I'm actually able to do that, but not. That's weird. Now, it's so weird. So this is S8 and this is S5, so then I shouldn't be able to write this down either, but I'm able to write this down. You tell me why that is. That I just don't understand that. And if I try to write this down to S1, then it doesn't work. Oh right, so these aren't single, this isn't single level, but But this is single level, so let's see if it can. Yeah, actually, but I'm right. So now I think I got it. So this I can't write down. Okay, so let's. How many terminals do I have? I have a C1 and I have a C7. So this. The weird thing is that I can write down to C7, can't I? I tried that and I was able to do that. Yeah. So I don't understand that. But I am not able to write down to C1. This is weird shit right there. There's some weird shit right there. Why am I able to write down to sensitivity 7 but not to sensitivity 1? I need to be able to reproduce that. So if it's not consistent and if it doesn't make sense, then it doesn't make dollars. It's that simple. So I'll make a C4, S4, ABC, 1, 2, 3, Xterm. I'll make an S3. Okay, and I'm just exiting this. So, ID. We have 4 and 3, so I shouldn't be able to write down from 4 to 3. Because I'm not able to write down to 1. And now it works. Scratch his head. Because I don't understand that. Let's see what my other log says about that. Yeah. She's a knight from 3 to 4, so well, I actually don't see the S1 nowhere in here. Oh, there's the S1. Okay, now, well, I guess I'm just... It's probably just working, but I'm just probably just not doing it right. But it, I am able, actually, you know, for example, let's just try this, to copy this over, copy it. And... Can I copy this to S3? Can I write this down? No, I can't. Can I write it down to S4? No, seems I can't. Can I write it down to S1? No, I can't. What do the other logs say about that? Oops. S1, S4, S3. So yeah, no, this is actually working. It's working, but I just I did something stupid or something. This actually is working, this network shit. though it's very slow, but and there's no sound. But the network controls are coming up next. But I'm just glad that this shit is working. So yeah, there's some glitches here. If you want this stuff to work, then you really need to take care of your clearance. So now I'm just wondering, and that's the last thing I'm going to test. I'm gonna log out. What if I don't have a full clearance? So let's say I'm new user, user add, and then Jane, password Jane, ABC123, SEManage, login as user you, and then a range of S0 to S5C1, actually let's just give it some category, C100, C200, C300, see if that actually works, because invalid contacts, and why is that? Invalid command, oh yeah. User A. Okay, this works. Now let's just log in with Jane. So ABC123. No, yeah, one is specified contacts. Role is user you, and then I'm just going to log in at S2, and then the high range is S5, and then C100, C200, and C400. And this is S. I need to hurry up before this stuff times out. Okay, let's open it up. ID. So yeah, I'm at S2. So let's just new role level. Let's say I just want to go to S4 C100, and actually I need to. S4, I need to actually let's just try it out, C100. And it actually works. Okay, so yeah, that was just, I'm just stupid. The weird thing is, oh yeah, yeah, no. That concept of clearances and lab and sensitivities is really looks weird. Yeah, so this works. Oh my God. Okay. So yeah, I just really need to get that through to my thick skull that you really need to take care of your clearances. Because if you don't log in with clearances, then shit just doesn't work. So let's just go over the policy that I had to add once more, just for reference. So actually, nano my X server te cd. So we had these MLS read write sysv interprocess communication. There was actually X server writing and reading shared memory of the user Windows Manager tempfs files, shared memory files. And I don't know what exactly that was, because I don't think that this window manager actually creates shared memory. But whatever it is, it was created with the with the Windows Manager type. So, but anyways, I had to basically add that rule that read to clearance and write to clearance for inter-process communication. And the same goes for socket read and write. And I think that was actually, I'm not sure what that was. I guess I could test it all out. Let's just try it out. And then I can actually see what it was. Sure, it's Linux devel make file. It's a module. Insert my X server. But I'm gonna log out before I do. Because, well, I'm pretty sure that those rules should be there, but I just want to be positive. So let's just last the X-server log. Okay, so we received the policy notice, and let's just log in again. I'll just take grift now, and ABC123. Yeah, rule, and then S2 S15 C0 C1023 and see it fails. So let's see what we got. And now we need to check out the old log, not because basically X server restarted. So old, and then all the way down. But I'll be damned. Supposedly it's the old log. Fuck. And actually it might actually not just not show in enforcing mode. So let's just do that in permissive mode, then at least it'll show that one, I guess. That's also a weird thingy. S2, S15, C0, C1023. See, now you also get all those icons and all that other shit. And now let's just check out the log again. And it's just don't audit it, I guess. Damn. Let's just try alt just for. It's just don't audit it. Shit. I guess. Because it basically, or actually, it might actually just not be an xserver log. It's actually not an xserver log. Fuck. It's in just var log messages. Because it's not an actual xserver thingy. It is an xserver thingy, but not an xserver object thingy. Last var log messages. Just so also so this is not it. This is it. Read and write the Unix stream socket. This is actually why I added those rules. So yeah, xserver on a low level with full clearance is trying to read and write a Unix stream socket on sensitivity tool with full clearance. So that's why I added those rules in, and yeah, that's just basically just needed. Damn, and I added SEModuleDB just for nothing. And then I added this one. Yeah, I'm not sure if this is actually needed. Might not actually be needed, but I added it anyway. Then some state stuff that's also not. And then we have this one. Let's first discuss. Let's just get it. So net write within range for user and for the window manager. This is actually the user and the window manager connecting, stream connecting, so it's the connect tool permission on the Unix stream socket for xserver. So that's not such a big problem. But this one here is a problem. This is a problem. And this isn't such a big problem either. This is just xserver writing some user objects, I think, for which it is cleared, I guess. And this send event, I'm not sure. This is actually, yeah, this is also important. Because I think this one is needed one of them is actually needed to this is actually the one to send, to click, to actually get, to send an event by clicking some object, some something. This one. And then this one is just needed so that namespace init can actually create or copy the scale files into directories that are, that have a higher sensitivity than the sensitivity of namespace itself, but it's in within its range clearance. So, and that's basically it. So the only really big problem is, as far as I can see it, is this one here. This is just plain writing down. But fortunately, those are only X Windows objects. So yeah, that's that discussed. So then, so if anyone wants to actually see, what AVC denials that are with related to users writing down to X Windows objects, let me know and I'll show those. It's a bunch of rules actually, and without it, it just doesn't work. And there's no better okay, so that's basically it.